Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're going to be checking out Fiji Cube's magnetic frag racks. If you've got frags that you need a safe place for, but are tight on space, and want a clean looking, low profile rack that will fit a bunch of frags, not only neatly, but securely, so you can hit them with all the light and flow they'll need without worrying about them jostling around, then you've got to check out Fiji Cube's magnetic frag racks. Their locking feature is huge for me personally. I've had, I don't know, how many snails and wrasses over the years knock frags all over the place, making a big old mess. Peace of mind. Coral frags are an inevitability when it comes to reef keeping. Even if you adopt a tank filled with large colonies, you'd eventually need to do some trimming as the corals grow too close together, and you'll find yourself looking for a safe place to put those frags. More likely though, you'll be getting lots of frags from your local fish store, frag swaps, fellow reefers, or even shipped from your favorite online vendor, and you'll want a safe spot for them while you decide where in your tank you want to glue them down so they can grow out. And if you're anything like me, that could take a few days, maybe weeks. I can be pretty indecisive. Leaving frags resting on your rockwork or in the sand bed is a recipe for damaged corals. If I had a dollar for every time I heard about a frag that was on the sand bed and got knocked over and buried, or was just sitting on the rockwork and got knocked over by a snail or a wrasse and landed on another coral and damaged it, I'd be able to fill that tank behind me wall to wall with corals for free. And that is one of the biggest reasons why magnetic frag racks have become one of the most popular options out there. Fiji Cube nailed it with their sleek magnetic racks. They're built with black cast acrylic with a nice clear blue accent acrylic on the bottom and have a great locking system to hold those plugs in place sandwiched in the middle. Fiji Cube used N52 triple coated neodymium magnets to hold those racks firmly in place and also made the racks modular so they could be taken apart for cleaning, which is a really nice touch. I'll show you how to take them apart in just a bit, but first, gotta get them out of the boxes. In the box, you'll find the magnetic frag rack with the included magnetic mount. The racks are available in three sizes, including an 8 plug, a 16 plug, and a 32 plug version, and range in length from 8.25 inches up to 11.35 inches. They're designed to hold plugs with a 0.5 inch diameter stem or smaller, and each hole is spaced 0.5 inches apart. All three sizes will hold firmly on panels up to half an inch thick using watertight acrylic encased magnets. The platform of these racks is only 3/8 of an inch thick, and the black acrylic hides really nicely on the back of a tank with a black background. The transparent blue lower does a good job of minimizing the overall silhouette of the rack, and the rounded corners look great. Also, if you like taking pictures of your frags separated by fluorescent acrylic rods like these, the solid black of the rack does a great job of making those rods super visible and makes for a nice clean backdrop for those WYSIWYG posts. Now, my favorite part of these racks is actually the plug locking system. In between the upper and lower portions of the frag rack, there is a softer white material that provides 5 nubs inside of each of the holes of the rack. These nubs provide some pressure and resistance on the stem of the frag plug and prevent it from being easily bumped around or jostled, which is brilliant. This is especially helpful if you have plugs with thinner stems that don't sit nicely in a standard half-inch hole or in egg crate, or if you have any snails or fish that are notorious for knocking frags around. I've even had a full rack of SPS frags get shaken up just by the flow needed to keep those frags happy, and this locking feature solves that problem. The last thing you want is your prized frag tumbling off the rack and into the sandbed and getting buried, or in between the crevices of your rockwork, or worse, into another prized coral. That just makes my skin crawl, and that's why this locking feature rocks. Fiji Cube did something interesting and used a removable plastic rivet system to assemble their racks so that they could be taken apart for maintenance. I can definitely appreciate that, and although the layers are held together tightly, there's likely going to be some debris or algae that makes it in between the sandwich locking layer over time, or even just on the nubs themselves, and being able to get in and clean it out is great. That way you can always keep the frag rack looking new, even after it's been in use for months. Speaking of new, before you add any new corals to your magnetic racks, you want to make every effort possible to make sure you're not getting any unwanted coral pests coming along with them, and starting with a great dip solution is a great way to just knock off the nasties so they don't end up in your tank. Ryan and Randy have a great video you can check out right here on the top coral dips of the year, walk you through the different types of dips, why one might be better than the other for specific situations, so you can pick out which coral dip's going to be best for your corals as well as your budget. So go ahead and check it out, and then you can put your clean corals on your slick racks.